Okay guys, my name is Jonathan Wu, and here I will show you how I will give introduction of the T3's products. From T3 Innovation, we provide a solution for network cable testing. Here we have three major models that have different features. And usually when people talk about cable tester, people are talking something like this, very simple, very cheap. And what it does is it can help you to test the continuity of the data cable like this. So it will show you whether there's an open or whether there's a short inside the cable, so you can make sure the cable you are using is good. But from T3, we offer more features, and we will start from the most basic model, cable powder. So cable powder here can do have three major features. The first one would be cable testing. You can do continuity test, wear map testing, distance to open, distance to short. And usually when it comes to cable testing, we have two major standards to follow. One is TIA 568A, and the other one will be TIA 568B. And this one can be applied to Cat3 cable, Cat5E, Cat6, Cat6A, coaxial cable, and telephone cable. So I know sometimes you may have customers that come out to say, hey, do you have a tester for Cat6 cable or Cat6A cable? And actually, all the T3 product can cover all these different type of Ethernet cable, so it doesn't matter. As long as it's an Ethernet cable, we can test it. And the second feature will be the PoE test. Usually it's quite helpful because for some basic tester from other brand, they will say they also have a PoE test feature, but usually they can only tell you whether there is or not a PoE. Do you guys know what PoE is?
Power over Ethernet.
Yeah, power over Ethernet. So usually they can tell you whether there is or not, but they cannot give you details of the PoE, but we can. I will show you guys later. And the third feature will be the tone tracer. We have a tone generator inside the device, and you can use this to trace the cable all the way along. And the last one would be all the test results could be exported as printout report. So now let's get to details. Okay. So the first thing is cable testing. You can see you can use it to test even kind of cable, coaxial cable, network cable, K5, K6, K6A cable. And here is the result of the cable testing. You can get a pass, you can get a fail, and it will give you, this is what we call a wire map. You can get all the status of each pair inside the Ethernet cable. And here you get the length of each pair. Sometimes you will find that the number here is different. That's because in Ethernet cable, it's all twisted. So since it's twisted, so the length will be a little bit different. So that's the reason why. And if you get a fail, the device will show you why you'll get a status. So let's say if there's a short, there's an open, there's a reverse, there's a split, you can find it here. So this is PoE testing. So like I said, some of the test device from other brand, they can tell you whether there is or not PoE, but from T3, the PoE test we talk about is we can tell you the details. So this is a voltage of your PoE. And usually the reason why people need this is, let's say you have a job and you have to install IP cameras into the systems, and before you install the IP camera, you need to make sure there's enough power voltage on the Ethernet cable. So you can use this to measure the voltage to make sure that you get the power all you need for the IP cameras. So this is very handy. And the upper column here shows you the capability of the switch. So you can tell whether your switch can support 10, 100, or 1 gig, 4 half duplex. And the last one will be the tone tracer. Like I said, we have a tone generator built inside the device. And you can use this, the tone tracer, to trace the cable. So let's say you have a bunch of cable, like 10 cables, and you want to know which one is connected to the device, then you can use these features to do that. And for all the testing results, you can export them from your PC, you will need an application, and you connect it to your device by using the USB cable from here. Then you will get a PDF report, CSV report, for all the testing you've done with the cable folder. Okay, so now I'm going through some of the accessories that come with the testing device. Okay, here. So this will be the two different types of remote you can get from the T3 kit. And this one, I'm going to go through this one first. This one is what we call the ID remote. So what it does is it can help you to identify the layout of the cable inside your customer's house. So let's say you got a new job and you go to visit your customer, and but you don't know how the cable runs inside their house or office. You have, so here you can see there's a multiple ports here. So you can just plug this with different number inside those ports. And from the other side, maybe the other side will be the IT room. You connect the cable to the cable folder, then you get a reading like this. You get ID number 9. So that means that the cable you connected ends here. So you can do this one by one and figure out how the cable runs, how the cable goes inside your customer's house or office. So this is the first ID remote. And the yellow one will be for the RJ45. And the silver one will be for the coaxial cable, for the coaxial connector, F connectors. And here we have a second type of remote. We call it a smart ID remote. And it can do pretty much the same thing as this one can do. It gives you the ID number reading. But the thing, usually this remote will be used when you have to perform the cable testing like this one. When you need to run the wire map testing, you have to connect this black small remote on the other side of the cable. So it will show you whether there's an open, there's a short, and give you the status of each pair. So you can see here, this is the cable you want to test. You have to connect one side to the cable folder, and the other end you have to connect this one. But if you only need to measure the length of the cable, you don't need this one. You just connect one side to cable folder and you'll get a reading of the length. But if you need more details, like say wire mapping, you have to connect this. So that will be the difference. Okay. So any questions? That's pretty much for the cable folder, the first model. Then now I will move on to the next one. The net chaser. So you guys can see it's quite similar. This is the cable folder, this is the net folder. And actually all the features included inside the cable folder are included in net folder as well. So if you have a customer buy net folder already, they don't need cable folder. It's all here already, all the features. And the major difference between the net folder and the cable folder would be the capability to test on active network. So for what cable folder can do is what we call passive network testing. That means you test a passive component like cables, you test a layout, you test PoE, and for net folder you can test more for active network, such as DHCP, you can get IP address, network mask, DNS server, and routers details. You can do a ping test. You can either enter the IP address or the URL. It can support both IPv4 or in the future IPv6. You can do protocol discovery for CDP, LLDP. You can do a throughput test, TCP, UDP. And then this one, what we call network mapping, is quite useful for guys who has to work with IP cameras. I will show you more details about this. So here for the cable testing is pretty much the same thing that we just went through on the cable folder. And here is more details about the active network testing. You get the reading. This one is moving for DHCP. Then the second one, ping test. Third one, network protocol discovery. And this is what we call throughput test. You have to do this test with a PC. So for just like a cable product, we also have an application on a PC for an air product. And if the customer want to do a throughput test, they have to do it with the application. So this is a network mapping. So what it does is you will scan the network that is connected to NetProller and give you a list of all the devices connected to the network. So let's say you have installed 100 IP cameras and you want to make sure whether they are all online. So you can check the list, see whether you can get all the 100 IP addresses from all the IP cameras. If you couldn't, that means that something went wrong. The camera is not connected. So yeah, and this is the three kits options we offer from K3. So that's pretty much of it for the NetProller. Any questions so far? Yeah. Okay. So here's the last one, the NetChaser. NetChaser will be the top of the line product from T3. And usually we have lots of customers compare this product to the Cable IQ from Food Networks. But actually our NetChaser can do much more. And the major function for the NetChaser will be the speed certification testing. So what it does is it can perform a stress test on your cable. So that's why you want to make sure the cable you are using is good for the bandwidth of 1 gigabit. You can use the NetChaser to make sure of that. That's quite important for some of the people in the IT industry. As for the other features like cable testing, ping test, active network testing, like most of the features that came with the cable product and NetProller can be found on NetChaser as well. So usually if a customer they have a NetChaser, they don't need to buy cable product or NetProller because it's all here. So let's go through the features. This will be the cable testing. And when people need to do a speed certification test, they will have to use this bigger remote. It will come with a NetChaser. So how it works is pretty simple. Still, you plug one end to the device, and the other end to the remote, and you press the test key button. Then the device will start to perform the speed certification test. And at this moment, what the device does is it's running three different tests. One is signal to noise ratio, and the second one is skew test, is a propagation delay between each pairs, and the third one will be bit error rate test. So by doing these three kind of different tests, we use this to speed certify the cable for up to 1 gigabit. So at this moment, the NetChaser is actually throwing out real data packet into the cable and see how it works. And at the end, if it passes, you get a green check mark here. So it tells you that this cable is ready to go for the 1 gig transmission. And because it's throwing out real data packets, so actually it will cost a little bit longer, about 20 to 30 seconds to do a speed certification test. But it's very accurate. But sometimes maybe a customer, they say, okay, sometimes I don't need to do all these tests, I just need to do a basic cable test. In that case, we just use this small remote to save time.
You don't need to switch it off?
No, you just plug in and just press the test button again. So when doing a speed certification test, it will take 20 to 30 seconds. But if you're just running a basic cable test, it would only cost you 3 to 4 seconds, very fast. So you can see the result here. So here you only get the wire map readings and length of each pair. You don't get a reading for SNR, skew, or bit error rates. So that's the difference. And also, when you run a speed certification test, when it passes, you get a green check mark here. But when you are doing a basic cable test, if it passes, you get an orange check mark. And if you fail, if the test fails, you'll get a red check mark. So that's the difference between the speed certification test and the cable test. So here we quickly go through all the features for active network testing, pretty much the same thing for on the NetProller. Here you can see it's a ping test. Same here, you can enter URL or you can enter IP address. And here's a port discovery. So let's say you just enter your customer's house and you want to know some detail of the network, you can just use a jumper cable and plug into one of the RJ45 output in your customer's house, and you'll get all the readings, all the information of the network systems. And this is a trace route testing, protocol discovery. It just depends on how many details you need to get. So for the NetProller, it's the same thing. You can get all the test results from the device, but unlike on CableFrawler or NetProller, you will need to use a PC application and connect through a USB cable to get access to those reports. On NetChaser, it's all saved in the SD card. So you don't need an extra application. The file is all here. So you just need a card reader to get access to those files. So here we can quickly go through, let me see. Yeah, so this is a kit. This is the kit option we offer for NetChaser. So here will be the active network remote, and we offer one small remote for cable testing. And also you get a set of ID remotes like this one. So it all comes in one kit. Yeah, so that's pretty much of it. Any questions? Or you guys can come forward and have a play on the devices here.
Yeah. That's it.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
I think you can have a test, have a few, so play.
Yeah. So we have accessories here, cables here. You can actually do some testing with the product.
The basic ones. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do they all run on?
Oh, the NetChaser run on lithium battery. Yeah, but only on NetChaser.
I think that's the top one. So yeah. But yeah, okay, we order more of this one. I think we run on short or something. But yeah. This use the full finder, very, very accurate, and checks the length of the cable is very accurate too. So some devices you need calibrate, but this one doesn't.
Phone, do we still have some time left?
Yeah,
okay. Okay, so since we still have some time, here I would like to go through another model from T3, but it's more basic one, the gray one. So unlike CableFrawler, NetProller, and NetChaser, they are all mainly designed for the application on the Ethernet cable. Here we have a more basic model, we call it coax clarifier. It can only be used on dark coax systems. So basically, it's a coaxial cable testers. So like most of the cable testers can do, it can measure the length of the cable. It gives you distance to open, distance to short. That's very basic. And there's a special features on this product that is what we call quality test. But sometimes the customer will be confused by the quality test. What is quality test? Because most of the people they work with CCTV or CATV, they would like to measure the actual signal strength of the systems. So sometimes when we talk about quality tests, they will be confused and say, are you saying measuring the dB from the signal? But actually what this device does is not like that. The coax clarifier, what it does is it will send out the 7.5 megahertz signal into the cable, coaxial cable you connected, and then measure the return loss of that signal. And then you will get a reading, start from 0 to 40, And if you get the reading you get is below 20 dB, that means that this cable is not good, or the whole system is not good. But you can get a reading above 25 or 28, or sometimes maybe above 30. That means that the coaxial system you connected to is quite good. So it gives you a rough view of the coaxial system you're testing. And when you do the test, like here, you will have to terminate all the output here. So it will be easy when you're testing just one single cable. But when there's a splitter here involved, you can still test. You can still run this quality test, but you just need to make sure that all the output is terminated. Otherwise, the test will not succeed. Okay, so this is how it works with a splitter involved. And so this is what I just talked about. You have to use a terminator to terminate a split, to terminate the splitters. And this feature can not only be used to test a cable. If you have a splitter and you want to know whether the performance is good or not, just want to check, you can use this to connect to a splitter, use a jumper cable and connect it to the splitters and terminate all the output of the splitter, and you will get the same quality test reading as well. So it's pretty much like this one here. So here the 1.5 in my office, the result is 18.6 dB, and that means that this splitter is not good. Maybe there's something wrong inside, but just don't use it in your systems. And this is this graphic gives you an idea how you can use the coax clarifier, this product. And also like this kind of ID remote we just went through with other products. Coax clarifier, they can also be used with this coaxial specified ID remotes. You can identify the layout of the cable systems. And here we have a bigger one. Okay, so two of these remotes can do the same thing. It gives you the ID number so you can identify the layout. But when there's a splitter involved, you have to use this one. So the smaller one only works with single cable. And when there's a splitter involved, you have to use the bigger one. And the number we provide, the ID number we provide for the bigger one is starting from number 1 to number 6. And the smaller one is from number 1 to number 12. So here's a demonstration, pretty much the same thing, but this time we use the ID remote for coaxial cable. So here you can connect the remote to multiple output with a different number. Then from the other side, you have a bunch of cable. You connect each one of them to the device one by one, then you get a reading. So it's very easy for you to tag different wires so you can know where they end. And the coax clarifier can also be used with the same tone tracer here. It's all compatible. And we offer different kit options for this product as well. Okay. So that will be all four models that I brought here this time. So right now you guys can come forward and have a play with it. We have